Hi and welcome to science class. Today I am going to show you leaves that are not completely green in color, because in the previous video you have studied that to carry out the process of photosynthesis the leaves should contain pigments called green color pigments called chlorophyll. But there are few plants who have variegated leaves, that is the leaves with different color. So the question would be whether they carry out photosynthesis or not, or in other words we can put a question that does photosynthesis take place in these leaves or not. In that case I would say yes, and I would like to show you the croton leaves. How do they look? Here you can see this is leaf of a croton plant. Okay, it's a show plant, which is also an indoor plant, and you can see the upper surface is not completely green in color. Somewhere you can see yellow tint, somewhere green, and at the back you can see it's brownish in color. Okay, but still these leaves, here another one I have with me, here you can see, but still these leaves carry out photosynthesis. Why? Because their colors, different colors, under the different colors they have green pigments present. The large amount of red, brown and other pigments mask the green color. Mask the green color matlab cover the green color. Jaise ek color lagaya, uske upar wo sukhne ke baad uske upar dusra color lagaya, to kya hota hai ki niche ka color chip jata hai. So this is how it happens. The plants which have different colored leaves, those colors are masked, putting a mask over the green color, and so they carry out, as green colored pigment is present in the leaves which is not visible directly, it carries out photosynthesis. Okay, you often see slimy green patches in ponds or stagnant water bodies. Stagnant matlab thehra hua pani, jo sthir kisi jagah pe pada rehta hai usko kehte hain stagnant water bodies, and these are generally formed by the growth of organism called algae, and they contain chlorophyll which gives them the green color, and algae can also prepare their own food by photosynthesis. Algae are normally green in color. Somewhere you can find a little variation in their colors, but algae, jene tame gujarati ma kahiye chhe lil, apne kahiye chhe lil, they are algae, and they are found mostly in the water bodies which are steel. Steel matlab sthir pani hoye che, thehra hua pani hota hai, uske andar ye aapko dekhne ko milega. Synthesis of plant food other than carbohydrates. Let's see, other than carbohydrates, what else plants synthesize. Okay, synthesizing carbohydrates, the process photosynthesis that we have studied in the previous video. Now let's see what else does a plant synthesize from the raw materials they take in. The carbohydrates are made of carbon, hydrogen and oxygen. These are used to synthesize other components of food such as proteins and fats. Carbon, hydrogen and oxygen are used to synthesize other components like proteins and fats present in food, but proteins are nitrogenous substances which contain nitrogen. Now from where does the plant obtain nitrogen from? And as we know, nitrogen is present in gaseous form in the air in abundance. Abundance matlab bahut sari quantity mein nitrogen is available in the air, but it is not absorbable by plants. Plants cannot absorb nitrogen in the gaseous form. Then what happens? How do they take in nitrogen? Soil has certain bacteria that converts gaseous nitrogen into a usable form and release it into the soil. अब सॉइल के अंदर जो बैक्टीरिया प्रेजेंट है वो क्या करते हैं, एयर में से, सराउंडिंग में से गैसेस नाइट्रोजन को लेके वो यूजेबल फॉर्म में कन्वर्ट कर देते हैं और उसको सॉइल में मिला देते हैं. दीज आर एब्जॉर्ब एंड दीज यूजेबल फॉर्म ऑफ नाइट्रोजन इज बीइंग एब्जॉर्ब बाय प्लांट्स अलॉन्ग विद वाटर. ऑल्सो यू माइट हैव सीन फार्मर्स एडिंग फर्टिलाइजर्स rich in nitrogen to the soil, and in this way the plants fulfill their requirements of nitrogen along with the other constituents, and plants can then synthesize protein and vitamin. The carbon, oxygen and hydrogen present in carbohydrate, which is produced during photosynthesis, can only synthesize proteins and vitamins if plants consume nitrogen. Nitrogen is required along with the other constituents. Now let's move on to the next topic, other modes of nutrition in plants. In the previous video I had explained you, I had told you that there are two major modes of nutrition, that is heterotrophic and autotrophic. Plants are considered autotrophs, but there are certain plants who follow the other modes of nutrition. So now you are going to study why such plants do not follow autotrophic mode of nutrition and which are those plants. First of all, if they don't follow autotrophic mode of nutrition, then which mode they follow? They follow heterotrophic mode of nutrition. Why? Because they have to be dependent on other plants or organisms. Why? Because they don't have chlorophyll. There are some plants which do not have chlorophyll, so they cannot synthesize food. As we have studied earlier, chlorophyll is must for a plant to prepare food on their own. So the plants which do not have chlorophyll, they cannot follow autotrophic mode of nutrition to survive. Where do they derive nutrition from? They derive nutrition from other organisms, just like human being and other animals do. And so their mode of nutrition is considered as heterotrophic mode. Their mode of nutrition is called heterotrophic mode. So in other words, we can say they use the heterotrophic mode of nutrition. Look at this tree, picture given in your textbook on page number 5. You can see the yellow colored branches with the leaves spreading or spreaded all over the tree. What is it? What are they? It's nothing but a plant which has yellow colored leaves, wiry branch structures, tiny, which is twined around the branches, and you can see the main stem of the tree, and the tree is host for this particular yellow wiry branched plant. It has yellow colored leaves, and this is the guest plant, and name of this plant is Cuscuta. What is it? Cuscuta, or its Indian name is Amarbel. What is it? It is Amarbel. This is a plant called Cuscuta. It does not have chlorophyll and it takes ready-made food from the plant on which it is climbing. So directly it consumes, absorbs, takes in food from the host plant, and the plant on which it climbs, it is called host. Since it deprives the host of valuable nutrients, Cascuta is called the parasite. Parasites are those organisms which completely depend on the host living organism, and due to which what happens, the host organism gets deprived of many valuable nutrients. इसका मतलब ये है कि parasites वो organisms है वो जिसको चिपक के रहते हैं और जिसके पास से food के लिए dependent होते हैं, उस host को nutrients की कमी हो जाती है. वो कभी सोचता नहीं कि जिसके पास से food ले रहा है उसके पास खुद के लिए कोई food रहेगा या नहीं, तो उस organism को कहते हैं parasites. So amarbel is that type of plant which is a guest plant. It takes away valuable nutrients from the host on which it is clinging to or climbing on, so they are considered as parasites. Now have you seen or heard of plants that can eat animals? Yes, there are few plants. They have or they take nutrition by capturing the insects that enter their flowers to suck nectar from it. Such plants may be green or of some other color. Look at the figure 1.6. Here you can see, this is picture of pitcher plant. It's a pitcher plant, and you can see the shape of the leaf which is modified into pitcher. આપણે ગુજરાતીમાં કુંજો કહીએ ને, એક પોટ કી તરહ, અ પોટ વિથ લોંગ નેક, દેટ્સ કોલ્ડ પિક્ચર. એન્ડ ધ લીફ ઓફ ધીસ પ્લાન્ટ ઇઝ મોડિફાઈડ ઇન ટુ અ પિક્ચર. ઇટ ઓપન્સ વેન ધ ઇન્સેક્ટ એન્ટર્સ this pitcher or pitcher shaped leaf to consume the nectar, because they get attracted by the shape and color of it. They get trapped by this modified leaf of this plant, and that is how they take in nutrition by consuming insects, and so they are called insectivorous plants. What are they called? They are called insectivorous plants, and see how they work. The pitcher like or jug like structure is the modified part of leaf, and the apex of the leaf forms a lid which can open and close mouth of the pitcher. Aap dekh sakte ho yahan pe ek apex jo ye leaf like which looks like lid of the jug. ये एपेक्स ऑफ द लीफ है, लीफ का जो फ्रंट पार्ट है उसको एपेक्स कहते हैं. ये थोड़ा बहुत ब्रॉड शेप में आपको दिख रहा है, एक ढक्कन की तरह दिखता है. नहीं, नॉर्मली लीव्स हैव पॉइंटेड एपेक्स, यहाँ पे जो एपेक्स है वो लिटिल बिट ब्रॉडर है. वो लिड की तरह काम करता है, और एज सून एज द इंसेक्ट एंटर्स द माउथ और एंटर्स द पिक्चर थ्रू द माउथ, the lid closes and the insect gets trapped in this. Okay, so there are hair which entangle the trapped insect, the lid closes and the insect is trapped. The insect is killed by the juices secreted in the pitcher, and its nutrition are absorbed. Such insect eating plants are called insectivorous. सो इस तरह से न्यूट्रिशन ऑप्टेन करने वाले प्लांट्स को क्या कहते हैं? इंसेक्टिवोरस. ये प्लांट क्या करता है, ये इसके अट्रैक्टिव स्ट्रक्चर के वजह से मॉडिफाइड लीव्स या तो फिर फ्लावर्स ही ऐसे मॉडिफाइड हुए होते हैं कि इंसेक्ट गेट्स अट्रैक्टेड, उनको लगता है कि फ्लावर है, वो एंटर होता है ड्यू टू द अट्रैक्टिव कलर एंड शेप. इट एंटर्स द मॉडिफाइड स्ट्रक्चर और बॉडी पार्ट ऑफ द प्लांट एंड देन द स्टिकी फ्लूइड विच इज प्रेजेंट इनसाइड द मॉडिफाइड लीफ जस्ट ट्रैप्स एंड द हेयर ऑल्सो इनसाइड इट. इट ट्रैप्स द इंसेक्ट फॉलन इन इट एंड उसको स्क्वीज करके उसमें से जो भी न्यूट्रिएंट्स मिलता है वो एब्जॉर्ब कर लेते हैं एंड दे यूज इट कंज्यूम इट एज अ फूड. और इस तरह के प्लांट्स को कहते हैं इंसेक्टिवोरस. इज इट पॉसिबल दैट सच प्लांट्स डू नॉट गेट ऑल द रिक्वायर्ड न्यूट्रिएंट्स फ्रॉम द सॉइल विच दे ग्रो? लेट्स सी व्हाट हैपेंस. चिल्ड्रन, इट्स अ क्वेश्चन टू बी आस्क्ड अबाउट द पिचर प्लांट. इफ इट कंसिस्ट क्लोरोफिल ऑफ और इट इज अ green plant, it carries out photosynthesis, but still why does it require to eat insects or other organisms, living organisms, to get complete nutrition? Yes, though it is green and it carries out photosynthesis, it needs some more nutrients which is not available in the soil. It grows in such type of soil where nitrogen is not present. Nitrogenous nutrients are not present, and to satisfy the need of nitrogen, they consume other living organisms, and that is why they are considered as insectivorous plants, as they consume insects to get the nitrogenous nutrients. They are considered as insectivorous plants. So they carry out photosynthesis for the need of their food. They get other components of food through photosynthesis, and the one which they don't get through photosynthesis, they get it from eating or trapping the insects in the modified leaf. And as its shape is just like a jug or a pitcher, it is called a pitcher plant. Okay, hope your doubt is solved. In the next video, I'll be coming up with other modes of nutrition, that is saprotrophs or saprotropic mode of nutrition. Till then, goodbye.